Hi friends, today we are going to deal about the British educational reforms. So we all know British came to India by the year 1600 and they started as a mere trading. Okay, so they didn't show interest towards education in the initial close to some 60 years. They didn't show any interest in the education reforms, but later on they showed interest. But first they didn't show interest, but there was some few exceptions to that. So we'll see about the exception. By the year 1781, Baron Hastings set up something called Calcutta Madrasa. Baron Hastings set up something called Calcutta Madrasa to study the Muslim laws. Okay. The main aim of this setup is to study the Muslim laws. So by next 10 years, another person called Jonathan Duncan started something called Sanskrit College. The main aim of this Sanskrit College is to study the Hindu laws. So a counter was organized. Okay. Also to say, by 1800, Wellesley started something called Fort William College. The purpose of this Fort William College is to train the civil servants for administration. Okay. So these were some few exceptions in the initial periods, but later on the interest was shown to the education reforms. Okay, this is the year and the setup by whom. So next we will see one thing. Actually, when starting the education reforms, there were two thoughts. Okay, first thought is whether to educate the whole Indian mass or to educate the only few. Okay, the upper middle class. The second thought is the medium of instruction, whether to teach in vernacular. Vernacular means the local Indian languages. Whether to teach in vernacular or go with the English. Okay, there were two confusions. So by the year 1835, a notification was done by Macaulay, famously called the Macaulay Minute. He broke that two thoughts. Okay, first thought I told, whether to educate the full Indian mass or to educate only the upper middle class. So he gave something called downward filtration theory. This is nothing but educating the only upper middle class. Okay, that is filtrating the downward people. Okay, he told that upper middle class is only responsible for promoting education to the downward section of the people. Okay, so this is the downward people are filtered, only the upper middle class are educated by this Macaulay Minute. And also I told, the second thought was the confusion whether to go with vernacular or to English. He told that only English, we should go for education only in English. So these two thoughts were broken by Macaulay Minute in the year 1835. These are the recommendations. Okay, also one point to note here, just a fact, James Thompson, this is the he is the only first person to introduce schooling in vernacular languages. Okay, when all are talking about English languages, this person only started some school in Calcutta in favor of promoting the vernacular languages. Okay, this is about the famous Macaulay Minutes. Note down the year and get down the recommendations. Next we are going to the next reform of Woods Dispatch in the year 1854. This is very famous and it has been described as the Magna Carta of India. Okay, this reform is known as the reform of Magna Carta of India. And what is the main recommendation is, government of India should take the responsibility. Earlier it was the British government which took the responsibility of educating the Indian masses. By this Woods Dispatch, he told that the government of India is wholly responsible for the education of the Indian peoples. Okay, so that was a transfer of responsibility. And also he is the only, we are now having some hierarchy, right? Like primary school, secondary, then college, university. This hierarchy was given by the Woods Dispatch. Hierarchy means what? Vernacular primary school, Anglo-vernacular, at Anglo Vernacular High Schools and affiliated colleges at district level. So, vernacular primary school. Primary school will be taught only in vernacular, means Indian languages, and the high schools will be taught in both Anglo and vernacular languages. Also, affiliated colleges district level and universities in the township level. Okay, these were the hierarchy given by the Woods Dispatch. It is very famous and it is called as the Magna Carta of Indian reforms. Okay, also female education was promoted. One of the recommendations of Woods Dispatch is to the promotion of female education and scientific education. Also, when talking about female education, one thing to be remembered is Bethune School, started by G.D. Bethune, is the first school started in favor of for the education of the women. Okay, so Bethune School is concerned with the female education. Okay, this is the first school set up in Calcutta. That is with Woods Dispatch. It is very important. Several times questions have been arised from this Woods Dispatch in UPSC. Okay, next we are going to the Hunter Commission, next reform. In the year 1882. Okay, so what is this Hunter Commission? Is the main aim of this Hunter Commission is to only focus on the primary and secondary education, not the college levels and all. So the primary mandate of this Hunter Commission is to focus on primary and secondary education. So Hunter Commission gave that primary education should be reformed again. Okay, he told that primary education should be reformed again, and also the transfer of responsibility. Responsibility of primary school. Earlier, the responsibility of primary schools were tagged with the central level. So, he told that we should decentralize it and it should be attached to the district and municipal boards. The newly set up district and municipal boards were to be responsible for the primary school setup and the reforms. Okay. That he came with for primary, and I told the main aim of the Hunter Commission is to only note down the primary and secondary. Okay, for primary he gave that it should be reformed again, and also the responsibility should be transferred from the central level to the district and municipal boards. Next, in secondary he gave some two distinguishers. Okay, literary and vocational. Okay, after finishing high school, okay, the students should be divided into two groups. One to follow this literary means to university. If you opt for this literary, you will be leading to the university level and you will get a degree. Okay, if you opting for vocational group, it will be leading for commercial careers. I know this is still followed in India, okay, right? Literary and vocational group is there for commercial purposes. They will be dealing practical, okay, for their commercial purposes, for job oriented. So this hierarchy was given in secondary level, and for primary he has spoken about the transfer of responsibility. Okay, this is about the Hunter Commission. Next came the Indian University Act of 1904. So this Indian University Act was brought by a committee called Raleigh Committee. So I told, I hope you know about this Indian University Act. It was brought by Lord Curzon, because on that days the students were participating in the mass movements and political parties which were held in colleges. So to restrict this event, Lord Curzon came with something called Indian University Act. The main aim of this act is to regulate the universities. Okay, to prohibit the universities from entering of the students. Okay, so as usual we know, the universities were controlled, very much controlled, and the veto power of the universities were abolished. Okay, it is mainly in hands of the government only, and also there are regulations of university. The main aim towards scientific education, scientific and research. Earlier the aim of the universities is to only educate or impart education. Now by this act he told that the aim of the university should be towards scientific and education, scientific reforms and education, the transfer of aim, and also the regulation of universities. The members in the universities has been reduced, and it has been regulated. The setting up of syllabus, everything was under the control of the government only. The government only should fix everything here. So the universities were very much regulated by this act, which also provoked the Indians also. There are many provocation towards this act. Okay. The main thing noted is by this Rayleigh Committee only this University Act came, and the main aim of the University Act is to regulate the Indian universities. That is the Indian University Act. Next, we are going to something called Saddle Commission in the year 1917 to 1919. Okay, what is the main mandate of this commission? Saddle Commission is to reform the Calcutta University. There were many mismanagements happening at that time in Calcutta University. So this commission, the committee was set up to take care of the mismanagement in the Calcutta University. But the recommendations given by Saddle Commission also, he gave also recommendation about the primary and secondary education. That's different. Okay, so he came with something called the vernacular. Vernacular languages should be promoted in primary level. He told that the recommendation was given, and also secondary level. He told that 12+3. Okay, what is this 12+3? Is before entering university, the student should enter a 3-degree course. Okay, now we are having up to 12 you will study 12 standard, then 3-degree course, then university, right? So this system or formula was given by in Saddle Commission only. Okay, after this only they should enter the university. The main aim of this is to prepare the students for the university level. Okay, that was the main thing. And also the female and scientific educations were promoted by this Saddle Commission. The main mandate is to only regulate the Calcutta University mismanagement, but he gave recommendations for primary and secondary levels. Okay, the main is 12+3. Okay, remember this 12+3 with Saddle Commission. So next is Hartau Committee in the year 1929. So what he told is, he also told that the primary education should be based on the vernacular languages. He also strictly, he gave the recommendations towards that. And also for secondary, what he did is, he told that only after primary school, after completing the primary school, only the passed or only the educated students should go to the high school and university level. Okay. If the students are not performing primary, if they are not performing primary level, they should be channelized to the vocational groups. Okay, if they are performing best only, they should be go to the high school and university levels. If they are not performing, you transfer them to the vocational, that is commercial careers. Okay, that is the main recommendations of this Hartau Committee. The year is important. The recommendations for secondary commission is very important. For primary, he told that vernacular should be followed. Okay, that is with Hartau Committee. Next is Wardha Scheme. In the year is 1937. I hope with this year you can come to some conclusion, right? Because 1937 Congress was ruling. We have talked about the freedom movement, 28 months of Congress. Okay, so Congress was ruling at that time. So this Wardha scheme is formulated by the Congress. Okay, these all others were by the British. Okay, this only Wardha scheme is by the Congress. Congress formed a committee called National Committee on Education, and they come with something called the Wardha scheme of education. Okay. So the main mandate of this, or the principle behind this Wardha scheme, is to impart education through practice, okay, through practice or activity. Okay, this is the main principle of the Gandhi. So this idea was derived from the Gandhian principle. Okay, so what they came with the recommendation is, I already told, learn through activity. And service. The student should be devoted to community or social services. Now you are having NCC and all, no? So they are talking about that thing. Okay. Also, from 2nd standard to 7th standard, the education should be in the Hindi medium. Okay, Hindi medium. And from 8th standard only, English should come in. Okay. Till 7th standard, English should not come inside. Okay. From 2nd standard to 7th standard, Hindi only should be the medium of instruction. And from 8th only, the English should come in. Okay, these are the recommendations given by Wardha scheme. Also the handicraft, because I told it is a Gandhian principle, right? Gandhi means handicraft is there for sure. So also the recommendation is to include the handicraft in the syllabus of, okay, but what happened is these recommendations were not accepted by the British government, because we know Second World War came, and the Congress also didn't last so strong. Okay, that is the Wardha scheme. These recommendations were not taken by the government, but no have an idea about these recommendations. Okay. Also, one main disadvantage is, we all know about the Minto-Mohr reforms of 1919, right? So what happened is, the Montauk Chelmsford reforms of 1919. So what happened is, earlier the education was in the central level. Okay, by this Montauk Chelmsford reform, I told, we talked about this reform, diarchy was introduced in the province level. So when diarchy was introduced in the province level, this education went under the province, under the ministry level. Okay. So some mismatch may happen because earlier it was in the hands of the centralized. Okay. It was centralized. So reforms can be easily regulated. When it went through the provincial level, that happened some mismanagement or tussle. Okay. That is with the, we are talking about the Wardha scheme. Okay. Basically, the scheme, I told it is not taken forward by the British because Second World War and the Congress didn't last so long. These are the recommendations or the reforms of the British. So, what are the main drawbacks? There are many drawbacks. First drawback, I'll say finance. Not that much of finance was separated or channelized towards the British for the education reforms. Okay, in the budget, education got only a mere share. Okay, for the education. Next thing, female education. Female education was not that much promoted by the British. Okay, that thing. Third is scientific and medical. Scientific and medicals were not promoted that much. To have a proof of this, only 3 medical colleges were set up at during that time. Only 3. Now imagine how medical colleges and how medical universities were having. At that time, only 3 were thronging the India. Okay. So these are some drawbacks, main drawbacks of this education reform. Why that didn't go very much succeeded? Because most of the Indians were illiterate at that time. Okay. Education didn't reach rural masses or to the end corner. Okay. The main drawbacks were these only. So these are the education reforms by the British. So when talking about the education reforms of British, we should study about the Indians. Okay, what are the recommendations of India? What are the education reforms after independence? Okay, so first came the Radhakrishnan Commission. During the year 1953, during that time. Okay, first one is University Grants Commission (UGC) was set up in the year 1953 by this commission. Also, this commission gave a mandate that university degree should not be made essential for entering into the administration levels. Okay, university degree should not be made that much essential. Essential means very important. Okay, degree should not be made very important to enter into the administration levels. Okay, these are recommendations given by the Radhakrishnan Commission in the year 1953. And next major reform, I am talking about the major education reforms, not the every reform. There are many education reforms in after independence, but the major is Radhakrishnan and Hartog, and the we are going to learn about the Kothari reforms. These were considered important. Okay, major I am talking. So Kothari is what he told us, 6% of national income should be diverted to for education. And also you told 14 years of free schooling. 14 years of your schooling should be free and made compulsory. That was given by the Kothari reforms. Still now we are having 14 years of education was free and compulsory in India. This is by this Kothari reforms only. Okay. So also 3 language formula. So what is this 3 language formula? 3 languages means what? Hindi, vernacular and English. These 3 should be promoted. Okay. Now we know central government was trying so much to promote Hindi language, right? So at that time itself, Kothari was saying about this 3 language formula for development of these 3 languages. Okay. So these are the reforms, the major reforms after independence. And I talked about the British reforms, what they have done and the drawbacks and what are the reforms after independence. So these are the education reforms. Have a note of it. Thank you.